Shumai friendly eye, and welcome back to my channel. My name's Caitlin Anwin for anyone who's new here, and today I'm going to be your tour guide for the Hydref and Gaeaf Zoo, which means autumn and winter. We're going to start off in Hydref, the autumnal zoo, and this is going to be the grand opening of the zoo. I've not actually let any guests in yet, so I thought that would be a bit of fun to see the guests come in into the zoo for the first time. So the first habitat we're actually going to see right by the Hydref entrance is the cougar habitat, and this one was inspired by Life is Strange True Colors. I recreated the black lantern and that was a really fun one. And next up is the prairie dog park, which is a play on words really for the prairie dogs. I thought I would create like an agility course park, like a dog park but for the prairie dogs. And as we go up the hill, we have the beaver habitat on the right and the prairie dog habitat on the left. So there's a good amount of guest viewing area for the prairie dogs. You can see them all the way around the habitat pretty much as you go up the hill. And they're quite small little creatures, but you can see them quite well from here. And then on to the beaver habitat. This one is the vanilla dam. Beavers secrete an oil which can be used as a vanilla flavoring or scent in perfumes, and I don't think it's used as food anymore, but it can be used as like a vanilla. So I created an ice cream shop for the beavers, and at the back of the ice cream shop there is a river which starts off as a little waterfall, and then in the center of the river there is actually a dam, so it's a connection of the ice cream and the dam behind it. So the ice cream shop is the vanilla dam. And now on to the spookier section of autumn, because Halloween is in autumn, so I had to do some spookier builds as well. This zoo can be viewed in the day and the night, so I thought we would have a look at some sections in the daytime and in the evening, and of course a Halloween spooky build for the American alligator would be a perfect habitat to see in the evening instead of in the daytime. And this is like a spooky swamp with a little graveyard and this haunted cabin overlooking the swamp. The alligators are really difficult to spot in this habitat though, with the mist and the fact that they kind of camouflage themselves in the water, so it's very hard to see the alligators in here, which adds to the spooky factor of this habitat. I think I added in some logs floating in the swamp, so that kind of looks like alligators. You can't really tell whether it's a log or it's an alligator. On the other side of the alligator habitat we have the moose habitat, and this one was inspired by Guy Fawkes or Bonfire Night. In the UK on the 5th of November we have Bonfire Night to celebrate the stopping of the treason plot, and you can see the moose pretty good in this habitat because they are very large. I know when I first saw these in the North America Animals Pack Reaction Showcase, I was really shocked at how big the moose really are. So you can see these really well. The alligators being super sneaky, but the moose are really easy to spot. And this is pretty much the first time that guests have been walking around in this zoo, and I thought it would be like a nice experience to sort of see what the guests would see and walk around with the guests. But I will admit the crowds were making me feel a little bit anxious, even though they weren't real. So you'll see the bonfire for this one with the forested area at the back with a scarecrow Guy Fawkes sat at the front of the bonfire ready to be put on the bonfire. But the moose quite like wandering around in the river. I did spot that maybe I should raise the barriers a little bit for the moose so you can see a little bit more of like the full heights of them. I didn't realize having such short barriers meant that the barriers kind of blocked a bit of the moose because they were so tall. Nearing the end of autumn now, we have a collection of food trucks to go with the fairground theme for the ghost train in the back there. And these were built before we had the Europe pack with the actual food trucks. And I still think they're really fun and colourful, so I didn't really want to replace them with the new food trucks. Maybe we'll play around with those in a different zoo or in a different section of this zoo. And another Halloween section here. So this top part is more of like the spooky side to go into the ghost train. And the ghost train is actually a showcase for some spooky exhibits. And I had a lot of fun building this, thinking of different things to put on the signs, like turn back now, sort of thing you would see going into a haunted house or a ghost train in a fairground. And the ghost train is actually the second transport ride I built for this zoo. And I was kind of going for more of a mine shaft feel of the entrance of the ghost train to go into the cave. I was still thinking about mine shafts from Life is Strange True Colors. It's nice to go back and look at some things that inspired these builds and getting like memories back from my sort of inspiration for this. And like other ghost trains, as you are on the ride, you don't just see these creepy crawlies. I have put different decorations inspired by spooky scenes on the left-hand side of the train track. So things like coffins, skeletons, and witches' cauldrons, in between seeing snakes, scorpions and spiders. Had a lot of fun with the special effects with the Halloween sections. And you can actually see the boa constrictor in the exhibit. That's one of the ones that is slightly larger, so you can see that really well while you're on the train ride. And my least favorite exhibit, the Mexican red-knee tarantula. Well, any of the tarantulas really, but I picked these exhibit animals because they were all from North America. So now that we've been on the train, let's go back to the gondola, which is kind of designed like a ski lift up the mountain up to Gaeaf, which will be winter. And there's quite a blank space by the gondola ride down on the Hydref side. So I definitely think if I'm gonna stick to this zoo and not start a new one, that I will start off the next section by there. So there's a little bit more habitats or anything more interesting to look at in that area. But now we're up in Gaeaf. And I start off Gaeaf with a more Arctic theme. So the entrance and the gondola ride station have the Arctic theme to them. But I like that I have a lot of mixed styles in this, but it keeps to the same sort of theme with the snowy ground in winter and all of the autumnal oranges and reds in the trees for Hydref for the autumn side. And the first habitat you actually see is the Christmas themed habitat for the reindeer, and this was actually inspired by the Nightmare Before Christmas. This is Christmas Town, and you can see the reindeer down the hill and the back of the Christmas workshop, like the Santa's workshop, and some Christmas market stalls with the Arctic theme. These were really fun to create with the little stockings. And the color scheme for like this part of the map was all white and like an icy blue, so it wasn't like majorly festive. We could just keep to like a wintry theme with white and blue snowflakes, frostiness. And the next habitat is the Timberwolves, and the Timberwolves actually have a festive winter walk, like a light show in a forest. And the view for the Timberwolves isn't great for the guests, and I definitely noticed that my guests got a little bit cold in winter, which totally makes sense. It is winter after all, but I did need to actually make the temperature of this zoo a lot colder up here to be able to paint all of this snow on the ground and keep it snowy on the ground when the temperatures wasn't actually below 0 degrees on the map, and it wasn't currently snowing. So it doesn't mean that like my guests are a little bit colder in this area, but you can see the Timberwolves on this side here where I've put the food tray in the water, and you can see down into the light show and the winter walk as well. I will come back to this in the nighttime as well, so you can see the lights. The view on this area is just absolutely amazing though, because it's so high up on the map. This is like the highest point of the map really. So you can see so far in the map, or like in the zoo, but it kind of does show that I have not filled out a lot of this map, or a lot of the percentage of this map. And now we're walking into the glacier, and this is inspired by my trip to Iceland for my 21st birthday. And the Arctic wolves are actually the only mammal native to Iceland, so they were the perfect animal to create an into the glacier experience for. Still with the white and blue theme as well. There's a really good view of the Arctic wolves from this walk. I was really happy with that. Some things I do not see that I need to improve if I carry on in this zoo. But this is what the tour was for, was to have a look at what can be improved and what can be changed, or whether I just wanted to decide to scrap this one and start a brand new zoo. I don't know yet. You'll have to help me decide in the comments too. And the glacier habitat looks beautiful at nighttime with the blue lighting on the ground. And I thought it gave a really nice effect on the snow rock walls that I created on the left now. And the stripes in the rock walls are to symbolize the volcanic eruptions and the collection of ash in the snow as the years go on. And as it snows, the ash stays in lines in the glacier then. And now going out of the Arctic theme and into the European theme now. This is when the Europack was released. I love it. I love how I can see as I go along this zoo when we get new packs, because usually I stick to just the one DLC per zoo. So it's nice to see the different styles mixing in together. And this is the fallow deer habitat, and it was getting into the festive season, so I created a gingerbread house for them and a nice forested area. There's a lot of evergreen trees and forests for the winter area too, just to bring a little bit of color from just the monotony of snow. And I'm not really sticking to the white and blue color scheme anymore. This is just going to be themed per habitat, like how I did for the habitats in the autumn area. And you can see the fallow deer in between the trees and by the gingerbread house. These are super cute. I love the fallow deer. So more of a classic European theme as we go along now into the Eurasian lynx habitat. This one was inspired by the new year, sort of. Pantone's color of the year for 2022 was a color called Very Peri, which is the purple color you're seeing, and that was described as encouraging creative, courageous creativity. That's the one. So to mash up the courageous creativity, I created a high ropes course for the Eurasian lynx, and one of the lynx in this habitat does actually have the leucistic coat variation, the white coat variation, so I was really excited about that. They were being a little shy in the daytime, but when I come back to this habitat, when we walk through this at night, you will see the lynx in the background, but they were either hiding in the trees or hiding up in the cave at the back of the habitat. But this was really fun to build and really fun to watch the lynx walk around the ropes course, because they can actually climb on everything in the trees, but they don't quite use it as intended. And the next habitat is the alpine ibex, and the alpine ibex were once believed to be mythical creatures in the 18th century, I think, and the modern equivalent of those mythical creatures are the Capricorn. And I'm a Capricorn myself, and it was Capricorn season at this point, so I've created a Capricorn castle for the ibex, and this was one of my favorites because I got to use all of the new damage decals from the Europe pack, and I love making things look old and damaged. I really enjoyed that. And we have some ibex babies, I think, would you call them kids, because they're kind of goats, I don't know, but there was little ones. I was really excited about that. They're so cute. And all of the habitats from the Europe pack actually have the Europe pack lights with on the habitat barrier supports, which have the animal relating to the habitat on the lights, which was really fun. And the new goat climbing mountain. And this elevated path is absolutely beautiful to see the view of the rest of the zoo. So you can actually see the Hydref side of the map, or of the Hydref section of the map, as well as all of the space that we have left in this zoo. If I don't actually end up filling out any more of the zoo, I think it'd be fun to upload what I've done so far and see if anyone wants to carry on filling out this zoo with their own selection of animals. And up this very steep set of stairs, long set of stairs, luckily you have a good view of the habitat as you walk up, because otherwise you get a little bit bored walking up all these stairs. You can get up to the modern mountaintop restaurant. And I kind of lied, this is the highest point of the map, definitely. And I was debating whether to put another entrance up here so it wasn't too congested for the winter site, but guests hadn't quite got up to this area yet. I think they were too busy looking at all of the habitat animals. And this was the first restaurant I built for the zoo and in total. This one's really fun. I focus a lot on the view from this restaurant. So there was a lot of glass and a lot of seating areas where the guests could have their restaurant meals and look over the whole map. Just a beautiful view from the outdoor seating area. I think I might have to put some heaters out here though, seeing how many guests were shivering walking around this area. And you might notice that I've got paths connecting the autumnal side to the winter side. I was having a bit of problems with the staff members getting stuck in the wrong area, so they couldn't get to their section of the zoo. So I just ended up connecting the two areas, so the guests end up walking quite a while to get to each area. The idea of these was that they would only really get to the one area through the gondola ride, but it was just too tricky to manage my staff all the time, so I just ended up connecting them. You can actually see the alpine ibex using the goat climbing mountain as well, which is really fun. It's one of my favorite enrichment items, and I love that you have a really good view of this goat climbing mountain. And you can see it from lots of different angles, and the guests can see it. So the lights that have the specific habitat animal on them does illuminate the path quite nicely, but doesn't illuminate much of the inside of the habitat. But it's enough for the guests to be able to see where they're going at least. And this zoo is powered by wind turbines, so we have only renewable energy sources in this zoo as well. Because this is all in sandbox, I thought it would just be better to select the more environmentally friendly options, because I didn't have to worry about money or anything reducing the guests' happiness. And now you can see the lynx in their habitat. They were playing around with one of the enrichment items in the center of the high ropes course. And I've just put the torch on so you can see a little bit more. The torch is actually, you can switch that on using the L key on the keyboard for light, I assume. I wish you could see the lynx a little bit better. I wish they weren't hiding in the daytime. You could only see them at night, because one of those is the acoustic lynx. And even though the guests are looking a little chilly in this area, they are looking a bit cold. It does seem very festive and cozy with all of the lights on the lampposts and on the trees. I really, really like this. I think it feels really cozy, and I want to walk around it myself. I'm not even a big fan of the festive season, but I really would love to walk around this myself. The fairy lights on the roof of the gingerbread house are my new favorite fairy lights from the Europe pack. I really love these. I love that they're flexi color as well, so you can pick lots of different colors for them. And now for the wolf habitat with the lights on. How cute are the little wolf babies, like the wolf cubs, sleeping in this area? You can see them really, really well right up here, which is great because we can't see half of the habitat from the pathway, but you can see all of the lovely lights on for the winter walk, for the light show. But oh, it's so crowded in this area already, and I made quite large pathways for the majority of this section of the zoo. And this is the Christmas themed habitat inspired by The Nightmare Before Christmas. You can't see the reindeers well from this side, but you can sort of have a little peek at them through the mounds of snow around the habitat. And the lighting's just so cozy. You can see the light from the festive tree in the center and from the light lights on the barriers as well, and they actually use the fallow deer lights for the reindeer because they kind of look similar when it's just an image like that. And this is pretty much the last building that I did. It's a mashup of a few different ideas. The start is the concession stand for the Dolls Drive-In. This is the last habitat animal we're going to see as well, which is the doll sheep or the doll sheep. And this one was so fun to build, to play around with the new world light bulbs. And it's just perfect to see at night, so you can see all of the lights. The building is, has a Bernie's Bakes counter in it for the concession stand. And the little bear lambs, the doll sheep babies, they're so cute. This is the only place where the guests can use the restroom, so that's clearly not helping for congestion. This is the 50s diner, and I love this build so much. It took me so long to do, and it's just perfect to see at night with all of the new neon food signs, or the food themed neon signs. So fun. I love this build so much. I love the restaurants. I want to build so many restaurants. I love them. And I actually got stuck in this, so I just had to escape from the building. I got a little stuck on the ceiling, but I definitely will have to add more restrooms in this zoo so the diner isn't so congested. And now on to the drive-in part of the doll's drive-in. I'm just gonna swap between doll and doll. I never really sure how to pronounce that, but you can see all of the cars for the drive-in. I love that they got like headlights on and everything. And I started this habitat to have sort of melting snow, so it symbolizes like the weather getting a little warmer in this area, ready for maybe a warmer section of the zoo if we carry on with this habitat. But yeah, that is the whole tour of the zoo. We're in both sections now. Gaeaf, or Winter, definitely has a few more habitat animals than Hydref does at the moment. There's a lot more American and European animals that fit into the colder, snowier environment. Now that we've done the tour, we need to decide whether we want to carry on in this North American Taiga Zoo and start a new section, or we start a brand new zoo in a different continent and a different biome. So I would love your input in the comments, whether you would like to see this zoo expanded, or you would like to see a brand new zoo and a brand new theme that way instead. But while I was taking a tour around both sections and creating these time lapses, I had the zoo open for a couple of years, and despite how much money I actually spent on these habitats and buildings, I am actually making a profit in this zoo, which I was so surprised by. And also let me know what your favorite section is, autumn or winter, and what your favorite habitat or habitat animal that was included in this zoo. It's hard to choose because they're all my build, so like I love them all in different ways. But I really love autumn. I think the color scheme with the oranges and yellows and reds was really fun. And Halloween is my favorite holiday of the year. So the spookier builds, like the spooky alligator swamp and the ghost train, were really fun to build for me. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, smash that like button. And if you haven't already and you would like to, it would mean a lot to me if you could subscribe and hit the bell to be notified whenever I upload a new video. I upload on Wednesdays and sometimes a bonus video on Saturdays. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day and I will see you next time. Goodbye.